Gato Perro back with another video. Today I'll be doing kind of a throwback review on the Marvel Select Venom. Now, I never got to review him on this channel, and I had previously on the Perro Gato channel, which is a channel that came way before this one, and that failed to get any success. But now on this one, I've gotten a couple of requests to review this guy, and I decided why not. I never got to. I really like it. I never actually got to show you the detail or my opinion on it. So let's get started by first taking a look at the packaging. Alright, here's the basic Marvel Select packaging that has been decked out in the Venom style with a lot of different comic book like compilations in the back. Venom on the side, and we get a like black ribbon going across and a lie about a base coming alongside with it. But no, it does not come with it. Then we get a seriously sick picture of Venom right here. Really like how that looks. And then we get a prototype picture of the figure, which looks a bit different if you look at it, because it has more vampire teeth right here. And I am going to read the bio. If you don't feel like listening to it for like a minute, you can go ahead and skip. Otherwise, it says, the vigilante known as Venom is actually a symbiotic being consisting of human reporter Eddie Brock and a fluid, intelligent organism from outer space who feeds on his adrenaline, granting him all the powers of Spider-Man. When they first found each other, both had grudges against the hero, wreaking havoc in his life, but Venom later became a hero on his own, protecting the innocent and helping to stop several other symbiotic beings, and had to split off from himself. At one point, Venom bonded with a second symbiote, causing him to grow additional arms and heads, as well as driving him mad. Both Brock and the symbiote have since bonded with other partners. This 7-inch scale Venom figure features interchangeable hands and heads to recreate his various looks from over the years, including first appearance head and Eddie Brock, and a full set of madness heads and arms. And yes, I did stutter through that. And here we get a picture of Barbarian, Hulk, and the Rhino, which I also have. So that's it for now. We're going to take a look at the actual figure. So I'm pretty sure by now, during the year and a half that this Venom figure's been out, you've heard a lot of great things about it, about how phenomenal it was. And to be honest, they are right. Everything you heard about it is great. It is an awesome figure, awesomely detailed. Definitely one of the best. I do have my couple of gripes, which has kind of plagued a couple of Venom figures that have come out, even back in the Toy Biz days. And first, we're going to take a look at some detail. First of all, the head sculpt. It does come with three of them. This is the more modern Venom head sculpt, the one with the big tongue, the frown, and the white eyes going across. Looking sick as ever. A lot of detail going on in the tongue. A lot of frowny stuff going across his face. Green slime on the side. Teeth that are kind of shaped so his tongue can come out perfectly like that. All the slime is just painted on. It's not sculpted. We even get some symbiote on the back of the head right there as well. And his tongue is removable like this. And it just comes off. Not poseable. Kind of wish it was. And you even got some detail on the inside of the mouth of Venom. All the teeth are painted in perfectly. You have the gums right there. A lot of different paint variations. And his eyes extend to the back of his head, which is kind of freaky, but also really cool looking. And then the rest of it continues with a kind of a generic, not generic in a bad way, but in a good way, as in the symbiote texture that we get on a lot of Venom figures. A lot of little stretch marks going across the muscles. A lot of veins going throughout the figure. The big muscular back of Venom. The entire Venom logo on the back and on the front is sculpted really well. The paint is not like all cheaply done. It doesn't fade through with black or anything. Really well done. Not like Hasbro with that Agent Venom. But I'm not going to knock the figure either. It's a pretty awesome figure as well. The only problem I have is the fact that they overshaded some of the areas with a lot of blue. For example, on this arm, it's completely blue. And it's not a big deal, but it's just in comparison to the rest of it, it's just overly done. Even to the hands, it just kind of stops to a sudden black. But even the web shooters are painted here with the square over it, and there's even a little hole right there that also is along with the other fists and the other interchangeable hands that I'll get into later. Really cool abdomen. Then we get into the legs, pretty black. And not as much blue shading as the rest of the figure, and the feet right there. So really awesomely detailed. Now we're going to get into the interchangeable parts. He includes the original Todd McFarlane drawing Venom head, which is the original appearance that he had. And it looks really sick. This actually has more of a blue shading that I think matches the arm closer. But it doesn't have a lot of detail in the teeth. There's like 50 teeth in his mouth, his big grin. And it's much more bulgier white eyes than I'm used to, but it looks pretty cool. And lastly, for the heads, we get this half Eddie Brock, half Venom face. It looks really awesome. Has this Venom tendril going along on the right side, as well as a tongue coming underneath from the jaw. A lot of teeth being sculpted in. Again, you can get the detail of the gums on the inside of the mouth. The tongue detail, the same green slime. The other half of the Venom face. The only problem is that this has caused some controversy, saying that it is overly sized compared to this Venom head. Which I can kind of agree on, but it doesn't really bother me. We even get some nice shading and detail on the hair of Eddie Brock right there. Looks pretty cool. I kind of also would have wanted just a solo Eddie Brock head that we could have put on here. Because I know a lot of people could have customized it and could have had him like in his business suits or working at the Daily Bugle or any other things like that as well. He also includes a pair of closed fists, which also include the detail of the web shooter on the front of it. And these are also the ones you're also going to want to interchange with the added Madness tendrils that you can attach to the back, which I'll get to later. And his final pair of hands are these more smaller open hands in case you don't like those big overly sized hands. For his final accessory, he includes his Madness backpack that you can attach to him, make him even more bulky and menacing than ever. Looks pretty awesome. You just snap it onto his back and includes these two extra arms that are right here that are actually articulated. It has the elbow and it rotates kind of like a bicep. And it has these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 extra heads at the top. And I think all four of the ones in the front move, but the ones in the back don't. And you can pop them off in case you want to use them for anything or just leave them there. All of them kind of have the same smiling head sculpt. Pretty cool. Let's continue the same detail of the spider going up top. A lot of very gruesome symbiote sculpt going on throughout it. Pretty awesome. I cannot believe they actually got to do this. But that's the reason why we didn't get a base either. So for articulation, it does not impede any, by the way. He has a head movement that goes up that much. He goes down. He has arms that go side to side, in and out, bicep, single jointed elbow, wrist, just go side to side. They do not go up and down. There is no diaphragm joint, unfortunately. I was hoping they would have it the first time I got it, because the original Spider-Man from the Toy Biz line, the Amazing Spider-Man series Venom, didn't have it either, because he had the big button on the back, which I reviewed before, but unfortunately that didn't have it either. So it's kind of a disappointment. Waist joint, he has arms, legs that go out that, DC Universe Classic style, they go forward. He has thigh articulations, single jointed knee, and his feet just go up and down. They get kind of wobbly after a while, and so do his legs, so he kind of has the tendency to fall down if you have him with his backpack on. Fortunately, it's not too big of an issue with mine, but it is something to look at. Alright, so this Marvel Solid Venom has closer to 8 inches tall rather than 7, which is pretty cool, really impressive. Very big compared to all the Spider-Man figures. And I've already done a lot of size comparisons in previous reviews, including the Agent Venom if you're interested. And even my Amazing Spider-Man 2 Marvel Select movie figure review, in which I did compare them to the Spider-Man figure because I really don't want to take them out of the pros brand. It looks really good. And yeah, sorry for being lazy, but overall, I gotta recommend this guy if you don't already have him. He was to be re-released this year because apparently a lot of people didn't get a chance to pick him up earlier because a lot of people, like, it was sold out, I guess, or something like that. Hopefully you have yours. If you don't, keep looking out for it. I don't think it's that expensive. I don't think it's made out to be that much. Hopefully you have yours. That's all for now. Gato Perro, out.